what we need to do is install the Music Flow app on the mobile. So for this we will need to go into the Play Store and we'll have to type the Music Flow Player, and we have to download this app called Music Flow Player by LG Electronics Audio. So I'll just install this app on my phone. So the app has been installed. Now let's open it. As soon as you open the app for the first time, it will give you the terms of use which you need to accept, and then you need to accept the Google Cast service also. Remember, the Music Flow gives you the facility to listen to internet radio. So the Music Flow app is ready to use. Before we can use it, we'll have to connect the product. So you have to connect. There are many products which are available in the Music Flow category. There is a multi-room audio, there's a soundbar, portable audio and bridge. We have the multi-room audio, so we will click on that and connect. There you see, the speaker is connected. So I have Music Flow 1 connected to my phone. I can rename this speaker. Let me rename it to my main hall speaker, because I will be connecting the other speaker in my bedroom. So the main hall. So now the speaker I can identify as the main hall, and whether to check whether it's connected or not, I can just press here. So you hear a small beep, which means that the connection is now done. So let's see how good the connection is. So I'll just finish it here. And so the new Music Flow app is now ready to use. So as soon as this is done, you press start. It will ask you to choose the genre to which you want to listen. You have to choose three genres minimum. So I'll press Bollywood, Indie Pop, and let's say Bhangra, and press next. It will also ask you how do you feel today. Now this is a very interesting feature, because what it does is it takes your entire collection and classifies your collection according to different moods. And if you say that you're feeling lively today, it will try and play all the songs make sure that your mood remains the way it is or the way you want to feel. So let me press lively and finish. So it's asking me that cast your favorite music and radio apps from your phone and tablet to your Music Flow. So again, you can play from anywhere. Right now I'll just say no thanks. So here you see, I have the option of listening using this speaker, or I have the option of adding another speaker to this speaker itself. Now let's select a song to play. It's a very, very convenient app. You can use the balance, left, right, etc., etc. You can do everything on the app. Also, what you see in the app is you have an home option. As soon as you press home, this is how the home of the app looks. So your song is playing at the bottom. Then you have your favorites, you have your timeline, you have the most played songs here, and you have your playlists here. Also, what you see here are the streaming services. So as I said, you can stream the internet radio on your phone. So let's try doing that. So I'll try tuning into TuneIn, and these are all the stations which are there. Let's listen to a BBC World Service News.
Since then, Nick Bryant has been to Oxford, Mississippi, the home of the state's famous university, Ole Miss. It was a battleground during the 1960s civil rights era and is still the scene of an angry debate today about how the white South...
Let's look
at black
the sports in London.
Participation team. And it's going to be a massive year because, of course, there's the new Environment Agency contract that the Anglian Trust won.
So this is very interesting feature, because you don't have to go anywhere else. You can stream everything onto the same speaker using the same app. Then you have the music library. In the music library, you get all your songs from your phone's memory. There is a very interesting feature that I must tell you about, which generally people don't know about. So when we say that LG H5 and H7 are truly wireless, seamless wireless speakers, we really mean it. What happens is, if you have the Music Flow app on two devices and both the devices are connected to the same Wi-Fi network to which the speakers are connected, you can actually stream the songs from the other phone also on this phone. Without even you knowing about it, all the songs from that phone will start featuring in your library here and you will be able to play them. This is something which is really unique. I instantaneously fell in love with this service. Then there is a mood station. According to your mood, it will start playing songs for you. So as you see from my library, it has automatically segregated all the songs. In energizing, it has put one song. Let's see which song. Here is the song which it has put in energizing, and as soon as I choose that I need the energizing mood right now, all the songs listed under energizing will start playing. Again, something which is very interesting. Let's see what else is there on the app. You have the connected speakers. You can see all the connected speakers which are connected to the app. Right now I have only one speaker connected. I'll be connecting the second speaker very shortly and I'll show that to you as well. And we have the settings. So in the settings, you have the general settings, which has a user guide. You can create it on, switch it on. You have a gesture control also. So if you shake the device, the speakers will switch to the smart device. You have the music curation here. You can set everything on the speakers. You can rename the speakers. You can switch on and off the LED on the speaker. You have the IP of the speaker. And you have everything here. The speakers also need to be updated. The softwares on the speaker also need to be updated, so that can be done here. Then you have an alarm. So you can use these speakers for as an alarm also, which is again something very interesting. You have the music library here. You have the account management, the time zone, the advanced settings. So the mesh network that we were talking about, it uses a Wi-Fi mesh network to connect so that you experience seamless music without any drops, without any disconnections. And then you have the Google Cast controls, and that's about it.